In this video tutorial, I will teach you how to felt a very striking and beautiful tunic made of silk, adorned with elements of Nuno felting. I originally recorded and published this masterclass on YouTube almost 10 years ago, but now I have decided to translate it into English. Over the past 10 years, I have felted many such tunics which have always been in high customer demand. This garment is 100% necessary in almost every summer women's wardrobe. For clarity in the video tutorial, I will be making the tunic in a rich purple shade. To felt the tunic, you will need a standard set of materials and tools. Let's start with the tools. Your table should be covered with either bubble wrap or some kind of ribbed reinforced polyethylene film, which is convenient for felting and prevents water from seeping onto the table surface. You will need a spray bottle or a watering can for water, a simple wooden massager, vinyl gloves to protect your hands and to lay out and felt the wool, olive or household soap, and a mosquito net. Instead of a mosquito net, you can use a soft tulle curtain fabric or even an old tulle curtain you might have at home. Any model of vibrating sander will work. You will also need a bowl or plate with a diameter of 15-16 cm, but you can use a drawing compass, although it will be less convenient. For the tunic base, either a ready-made silk pashmina in silk pongee 4 or 5 will do, or a piece of silk at least 1.5 meters long and 70-80 centimeters wide. For the decor, choose from what you have: various silk scraps, soft silk cocoons, silk fibers, dyed locks of fine sheep fleece, various silk threads, neps, anything you have in your assortment. You can of course use viscose fibers, but I don't like adding them to silk because silk is a noble material, and viscose always weighs down the garment and its shine slightly cheapens the look. I use 16 micron merino wool, but you can add suitable tops of 18 microns. Choose something in the same color scheme, but don't forget about some accent elements. Let's start creating the tunic. Mark the middle of your piece of silk by drawing two perpendicular lines with chalk. One across the piece of silk, which will essentially be the shoulder line, and the other marking the center line of the garment. On this line, we will make the fastening line. So you need to draw such a cross on the fabric with a ruler. At the intersection we have drawn will be the neckline of the tunic. In this model, we are making only the yoke or edging around the neckline, so we need only this small section of silk for laying out the Nuno felted decor. I place the bowl not quite in the center, just a couple of centimeters from the shoulder line to the back, leaving more fabric for the front part of the tunic so that the neckline is deeper in the front. Cut out this circle with scissors. For working with silk, it's especially important that your scissors are very sharp and don't snag or pull the silk threads. Do not throw away the piece of silk you cut out. It can also be used in the project. Rearrange the silk to make it more convenient for laying out the wool. Spray the silk surface with water to smooth it out and to ensure the wool and decorative fibers lay evenly on it. Begin laying out the wool in a circle around the neckline cutout. Lay out the first row with thin strands, then the second row in the opposite direction, and carefully lay along the fastening line, thus forming the base of the felted detail, which will be the yoke of the tunic. Now, watch closely. I took a small piece of wool top and stretched it widthwise, creating a kind of lace ribbon, and laid this lace strip along the edge of the yoke. Then I carefully sprayed water over all the laid wool and started laying out various pieces of silk fibers, everything I planned to decorate this tunic with. It's very important that the silk fabric you use in decorating the panel is not thicker or denser than the base silk from which the entire tunic is made. Lay out neps, pieces of silk laps, all sorts of different fabric and fiber scraps left over from previous projects work great here, but choose them wisely to match the color scheme. Add thin mulberry silk fibers on top of the neps and fabric pieces. If you do the layout correctly, all the fluffiness will disappear during felting and the felt will remain thin and pliable, not causing the base silk fabric to bunch up. If you follow my instructions carefully, the felt in this case will shrink in thickness rather than in size. Next, I lay out purple degummed silk cocoons. I stretch them into a kind of ribbon for laying, but you can use any other decorative materials you have on hand. If you want to learn to work with silk decor, such a tunic is an excellent option. You will learn and create a beautiful, striking item at the same time. Spray with water again. I strongly recommend taking photos of each stage of the layout for your memory. This will help you in your future projects and serve as excellent content for promoting your work on social media. We leave the initial stages of felting the wool with the decor on the silk under the mosquito net off camera because it's very simple. You all know how this is done. Cover the layout with a mosquito net, spray again with water, completely soap up the entire area with a piece of hard soap, and then rub it by hand or with a felting stone like an iron, then gently remove the net and continue working. First, smooth the surface gently by hand. Then you can move on to working with the vibrating sander. Move the sander from place to place, counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, thus processing the entire surface of the layout. After processing the surface with the sander, remove the excess water from the wool and silk layout. Do this with a regular cotton towel. Just apply it and absorb the excess moisture. Turn your silk fabric with the felted ornament to the backside, cut the part intended for the fastening, and rub the surface again. Carefully, using the mosquito net or a gloved hand, treat the neckline edges. Rub them once more to make them smooth and neat. Rub the entire surface from the wrong side again with the sander. This will take another 5 minutes. If for some reason you don't want to or can't work with the sander, all the same operations can be done by hand, but it will take much longer. Next, the treatment goes only by hand. Rubbing movements, like hand washing, work through every centimeter of our thin Nuno felt. Since we are working with thin silk and a thin layout of wool and decor, there will be no sharp and aggressive felting of Nuno felt. Only gentle, light felting, no thermal shocks for shrinkage. Work with the material at room temperature, with your hands, soap, and gentle movements. In this method of felting, the felt will thicken in thickness, but shrink very little in size. You will feel this with your hands because the felt will become elastic, thinner, but will not pull the base fabric. The wool, which is between two layers of silk, between the base silk and the decorative silk, will bind these layers together, creating very thin and very delicate, yet strong and resilient Nuno felt for the main decorative detail on this tunic. The decorative wool is lighter in shade than the base fabric, so in the video, you can clearly see how it has penetrated through the base silk, thereby binding the layers of Nuno felt. It's very important to felt the wool properly without turning it into a dense cardboard fabric. It is essential that no threads or fibers separate from this decorative detail while the felt remains thin and pliable. Once the yoke felting is complete, rinse out the soap thoroughly. Rinse the garment in room temperature water, squeeze it out in a towel, steam it with a hot iron, and sew the side seams. By the way, you don't have to sew the seams. You can trim them with Nuno felt strips like on the yoke, thus connecting the silk parts. But here, your imagination will come into play. I invite you to watch a slideshow of the finished tunic I just made and several other tunics from different years. you enjoyed this video tutorial, I would appreciate your likes and reviews. I wish you successful creative experiments and look forward to your comments, requests for new videos, and questions if something was unclear. Subscribe to my channel so you don't miss new tutorials on felting and other textile arts. See you soon!